Alrighty. Greetings, this is Vodril, and welcome to Let's Play RimWorld, which is an early access game out on Steam now. The game has been, well, in development for quite a while, as far as I know. But the developers just recently released it on Steam. I was gonna wait because usually I'm kinda hesitant on early access games, but a friend played it and he really liked it. And I love the setting, science fiction, westerns, yeah. Love Firefly, etc. So we'll see how it goes. I'll start. I haven't got any idea what I'm doing, so this is not a guide, this is a blind playthrough, which probably gonna end pretty fast to start with. So, three options, or custom. Crash landed. Your faction will be a colony, starts with three people and some items, which I have not really any idea. Oh, that's nice. You start with one people. How the hell would that even work? Your tribe was destroyed by the great blood machines sent by the gods. I guess we'll start with the first one. Alright, let's see. The AI storyteller creates events like pirate raids, resource drops, or animal attacks. Their choices will affect the story of your colony. Cassandra Classic. Cassandra creates story events on a steadily increasing curve of challenge and tension. Phoebe Chillax. Phoebe gives a lot of time between disasters to relax and build your colony. But beware, if she's set to a high challenge scale, she'll hit as hard as anyone. Randy Random. Randy doesn't follow rules, he'll generate random events and he doesn't care if they are. Make a story of triumph or utter hopelessness. It's all drama to him. I guess Cassandra makes more sense. Some of them, one of the three is recommended for newbies, but doesn't say over here, so I don't know who of the three it is. Yeah, okay. I will play permadeath. This guy seems random, so she makes sense to start with. Right, a lot of time between disasters, and I'll need to figure out how to actually play the game because, again, I haven't played it before, so. A style of game focused on building a colony in a sandbox-like environment, threats appear, but they're extremely weak. A style of game focused on a base building, threats are scaled back quite a bit. Rough planets. Alright, what if I don't pick anything? Only permadeath. Let's not pick any of these and see what happens. No. So it's... Oh, they are the difficult settings. Alright. So we'll start with base builder, I guess. It's not the easiest, but not one of the hardest too. I have no idea what that is, so... Okay. Zoom in with mouse wheel or page up or down, pan, okay. Should I pick something? Also, does select a random site. Let's pick something. Something. Forest will have trees. I'm sure what this is, the blue thing. Apparently a little cold, the blue thing. The forest is better. This has a really good temperature. Alright, let's see. That's not bad. Temperate forest, terrain is mountainous. Stone type, slate and marble. I have no idea what that means. Limestone, marble, granite, limestone and granite. Ah. You know what? Let's write. Again, I have no idea. Also have no idea, so good enough. Alright, we'll start with three people. Caravan child. Shit, okay. Female colonist, born male. She disliked boy stuff and going to her mother's things all the time. Aha, okay. Bounty hunter. Nothing capable. Heat tolerant and zealous. Wow, okay. Cryo sleep sickness. Is that good? Is that bad? That seems bad. Wow. We have a lot of stuff. Nurse. Alright, let's see. Shooting, melee, social, animals, medicine. Medicine sounds like something we would need. Too smart. Depressive. Yeah, all right. So, for artistic, I guess I will need someone with shooting and melee to start with, and cooking. Maybe construction too. What are these double things there? He has melee, he also has medicine, we don't need another medicine guy. Cooking 7. Incapable of scary. Traits ugly. Oh wow. I guess so. Sure. So we don't have anyone to fight though. Well, I guess you have melee. Well known throughout Hornblood as a child actor. You have melee, you have some shooting, but nothing really great. Can I get someone that's good at fighting? I think 6 and 7 are pretty high. You have 6 on animals too. Incapable of cleaning. Hard worker. Heat tolerant. Also I need someone with construction actually. Oh, she has construction. But she has incapable of dumb labor. What is dumb labor? Again, what is this level 2? Basic awareness. Passion, burning. Oh, I think maybe they are better. Yeah, you get, they get a bonus on learning on where the red flames are. Okay. Can we get someone that's not sick? There we go. By 5. And construction 7. That's awesome. Apocalypse Survivor. God damn. Okay. She grew up, the situation worsened, billions died. In peaceful states descended into anarchy. Yukiko and her parents did whatever they had to survive. That's interesting. Luddite Rebel. Forsake most technology, that's not good. Nudist, optimist. Alright, that doesn't sound that bad. You'll do. You'll do too. I think we're good to go. Well, I have no idea if those choices were actually good, because as I said before, I haven't actually played the game before. Hopefully there is some sort of tutorial. The three of you awake in your cryosleep sarcophagi to the sound of sirens and ripping metal. You barely get to escape pods before the ship is torn apart. Sometime later, you land on this unknown RimWorld. As pieces of the shredded starship fall around you, you start making plans to survive. Alright. Will you actually give me a tutorial game? Yes. Move the camera by clicking and dragging middle mouse button or the WASDs. Yeah, I prefer the WASD keys. Alright. You have more colonists than you have colonist beds. Someone, okay, make beds. 100 lux weapon. Build a room. A room is composed of separate wall pieces with a door. Use the architect menu at the bottom left of the screen to designate where you want things built. Okay. Colonists will not interact with items with a small red X attached. Okay. Your colonists. Oh, this music is awesome. Yes, this is the start of the game, Azuki. I just started. I haven't done anything yet. Welcome back, by the way. Find the stockpile in zone section of the architect menu. Growing zones. Okay. So, we need somewhere to make beds. And I guess we'll do that to build a room. Let's see. Architect. Use the architect menu. Okay, and do what? Oh my god. I don't see a tutorial. Alright, stockpiles. I guess they're gonna be here. I don't know how big they need to be. There, stockpiles. Growing zone. Grow food. Okay. Build a room. How? How do you build a room? Structure. Wall. Not enough. Not enough stored. Place planning designations, don't do anything, okay. No, I want to make a room. How do I make a room, exactly? Apparently I can't make a room because I don't have any stuff. Alright, where is these resources that have X's? Oh, there I go. How do I select a forbidden item and use the controls at the bottom to unforbid it? Aha, there we go. This looks like a rough learning cave, indeed. Indeed it does. We'll see. I'm not sure why they started with forbidden stuff. And it's wood. Why is the wood forbidden? Alright, we have some animals down here, some more resources. Let me just go and make them all unforbidden. Maybe you do it to, if you want to keep something in order to plan ahead and you don't want them to use it. Alright, we did everything. No, what's this? Survival meat. Ooh, rifle. Nice. Female Yorkshire Terrier of Colony, age 4, wandering. No, I don't want to slaughter it. What the hell? That's weird. Equip weapons. Equip them. Select each colonist and right click on the weapon you want them to equip. Okay. Yukiko is our fighter, so you'll get this. I guess you can get that. Build a room. Okay. A room is composed of separate wall pieces with a door. But I don't have any. Oh, now that I unlock the resources, maybe I can actually use them. Let's see. Not enough. Man, they're hard to read the letters. Kinda blurry, at least on my TV. How big should the room be? I guess I'll make sort of a small area we can sleep in, maybe. Alright. Do I need doors and stuff like that? Furniture. No, how about... Oh, there goes the door. Can I change the orientation of the door? Uh-huh, it does it correctly. It's a bit two doors. No, 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 no. Cancel. We'll build one door, I guess, and we'll see. So this guy is moving. Oh yeah, I should. I think you need to assign them stuff to do. But we'll see. I guess for now, we'll do mostly everything. You can assign a tame animal to be trained in a specific skill of its training tab. Okay. All right. Let's build some beds. Wood. I don't think we need to do rooms right now. There, 3 beds. Okay, what's next?